If you are talking about the safety of the city, if you are talking about people's life not being affected by these violent protesters, I think that is of prime importance. And one more thing, the opposition always accuse the central government trying to intervene our business and stuff like that. And they always, by using sort of scaremongering tactics, they spread out the fear and say that is the end of one country, two systems. I say the opposition, those opposition leaders are the one to fear this national security law, because they could have done a lot of these acts, sedition acts, or I say only a few individuals who engage in those terrorism acts, they should fear. But the vast majority of Hong Kong people should never worry about this piece of law.
You know, you mentioned, I've got just a few seconds before the break, you say terrorism laws. First they were protesters, then they're rioters, now you're calling them terrorists. What is a terrorist act?
What would you call them if the people could beat up those a man to that extent?
Did you see the video?
They use explosives.
Do you know
weapons?
The meaning of the word terrorism?
What kind of word would you describe them? I couldn't figure out any word similar to terrorism.
That word
to describe
is one person
people.
Beating up another person.
So you disagree that that is not terrorism?
It's
by having
not
this
terrorism.
Very violent and cruel behavior.
You know,
oh, come on.
Look
this
up the word terrorism in the dictionary. Terrorism is when you plant a bomb and kill people.
Wow.
Wearing a terrorist bomb vest.
Go and watch the Telegram. You see a lot of message for these people to organize those crimes and giving a bomb to everybody.
Holding. Quick break. See you soon. Don't go away.